Hey everyone, as you know, I like to cover trans issues because trans issues are very important. Trans people are people too, and this is why, instead of infringing on biological women's rights, trans women should be fighting for their own separate competitions where they can compete against other transgender women. Instead of being misogynistic and being okay with infringing on the rights of biological women, it says a lot about a person, whether you're a man or a woman, you're a trans woman or a trans man, if you think it's okay that you can infringe on biological women's rights and then gaslight anybody who doesn't agree with you. Which brings me to this article titled Trans Athlete Laurel Hubbard Named Sportswoman of the Year. What's interesting is, Laurel Hubbard, you're not a biological woman. You should not be winning Sportswoman of the Year. You should be fighting for your own separate magazine or sports competitions or pageants where you compete against other transgender women instead of wanting to infringe on the rights of biological women. The article reads, Laurel Hubbard, the New Zealand weightlifter who competes on the women's team, though she is a biological male who identifies as transgender, has been named Sportswoman of the Year. So there you go, you guys. Biological women no longer have rights. The women's suffrage movement was for nothing because biological men can now compete and trump us in biological women-only competitions if they claim to be a woman. So all of our ancestors' hard work, all of the women during the women's suffrage movement that fought so hard to give biological women equal rights to men no longer matter. None of it matters anymore. Because Laurel Hubbard and other misogynistic biological men can easily trump biological women's rights so as long as they claim to be a woman. The article continues, the award was given to Hubbard on Tuesday. Hubbard was the first trans woman, biological man, to compete in the Olympics on behalf of a woman's team. Hubbard did not win or place in the weightlifting events for which the lifter had qualified, surpassing much younger female New Zealand lifters to gain a spot on the team, biological females. Hubbard received the award from the University of Otago in Dunedin on New Zealand's South Island. The Sportswoman of the Year award has never before been given to a biological male, meaning Hubbard's taking of the prize makes a notable mark in the 113-year history of the award. Hubbard was unable to make a successful lift in the snatch and was eliminated from the weightlifting competition. That's God's work. Hubbard told the local paper that she was grateful for all the support and kindness received from the teaching staff and the students at Otago University. It is not possible, Hubbard said, for athletes to compete at the Olympic level without the encouragement of friends, family, and supporters. This award belongs to everyone who has been part of my Olympic journey. We could think of no more worthy of Sportswoman of the Year than Laurel Hubbard, who represented Otago and New Zealand's incredibly well at the last year's Tokyo Olympics. Well, I could think of someone else that could win this award. A biological woman. A biological woman competing in female-only competitions. The award could easily go to them, but I just want to let you know, Laurel Hubbard, whether you want to acknowledge it or not, you are being used. You are being used by a group of elite globalists who are trying to divide and conquer. You are their puppet in order to brainwash their little minions and get them to vote a certain way and then continue to divide us and conquer. Sane individuals do not truly believe that you earned Sportswoman of the Year because you, a biological man claiming to be a woman, is demanding to compete against biological women and female-only competitions. Honestly, this is a joke. It's just another way to control the masses and keep us fighting with one another in order to control how we vote. Laurel Hubbard, you know what would be really honorable though and impressive? If you created your own sports and competitions where transgender women can compete And then you can be in charge of who wins Sports Trans Women of the Year. But like the article said, never in 113 years has a biological man won Sports Woman of the Year, because it's not sane. It's insanity. And you're being used. Anyway, the article is much longer. I will leave the link in the description below so that you guys can go ahead and read this wonderful article yourself. But I just wanted to share with everybody that, once again, biological women's rights are being erased due to biological men trumping those rights, all because they claim to be a woman. So no longer do biological women have rights free from men. No longer do biological women have spaces free from men. We have regressed decades, and now biological women, biological females, have to fight again and create a second woman suffrage movement because brainwashed idiots are allowing biological females' rights to be infringed upon once again. Republicans, Trump supporters, and conservatives are not the problem. It's the brainwashed zombies who think this is okay. They are the problem in America and across the world. It's not the people who have common sense and follow science and want to make sure that there is equality for all. Because right now, in the year 2021, there is no longer equality for women. Women no longer have the same rights as biological men. So that's it for this video. Thank you guys for listening. Please like, subscribe, have a wonderful day.